Welcome, everybody. I'm Chiara Tomasi, and I'm glad to welcome here at this new LiveWaves webinar session by Federico Nisolf Adhesives. As I was saying, I'm Chiara, and I'm Marketing Manager, Prime Papers and Brand Protection at the Federico Nisolf Adhesives. Today, during the webinar, we are going to talk about brands and how they meet different cultures. The title of the webinar is, in fact, Brands Meeting Different Cultures, the Rules for an International Design. Our guest speaker today is Luca Fois, Creative Advisor and Professor at Politecnico of Milan. During the webinar, Luca Fois will tell us about the impact of stereotypes and prejudices on design and communication by using a variety of case histories. Leveraging his long working experience in Asia, Luca will explain us how brands should develop through cultural differences while maintaining their identity. For any questions you may have, please use the chat box, and we will answer to your questions at the end of the webinar. We'll answer all of them or not. It depends on the time we will have. But in any case, consider the fact that you will receive an email, a follow-up email in a second on a second time with all you know, the answers you have popped out during the webinar. The webinar is recorded, therefore, in a follow-up email, you will receive a link to watch the webinar or rewatch it anytime on our YouTube channel. These webinar images may belong to third parties and cannot be reproduced for any reason. For any problem you may have, please use the chat box to ask support to our colleagues. They will try to help you as soon as possible. And now I leave the stage to you, Luca.
Thank you to everybody, and happy to be here with you. I am speaking from Sicily, and I'm very glad because Sicily is a very good country about the theme that I'm speaking today. And during the lesson, I will speak also about this. Brands meeting different culture. And this is really something important because sometimes the brand company don't are really oriented to the communication. That means to have empathy and to know the other and to communicate to the other, not to himself. Sometimes the brands speak in not a good way. And brand is brand strategy and general branding is a talk system. And so is something that don't is not only a logo, is not only a graphic identity, is not only an aesthetical system, but is really a relation system. And the relation needs to be in two or more than two, me and the other. And the other are very different. And so the topic of the lesson is to know the different culture and to use the difference as a value, not as an obstacle, or to don't know or ignorate this kind of aspect. And this is very important in the daily life, but mostly in the business life. So the king is the brand. And it's very important that we know that the brand is a mix of a material and immaterial value. No? And this is really what in design we speak about system. system design. That in general is product service system design. A brand is a system of many kind of aspects of topics. And this is really important because speaking with this company, Arconvert and Federigoni Arconvert, is very important because they work in the what is the very important basic platform to build a brand, because it's the material level, and the material is something, as we will see later, really important because it's something related to our sense. And some people can think that these are secondary problem or secondary skills aspect, but it's not true. This is really something important and basic because I'm speaking in different languages. So your brand is a story unfolding across all customer touch points. So the brand is related to the customers, is not related to the company. Yes, sure, comes from the company, but the brand is something related to the customer. And as the communication is always the responsibility of who communicate, not who listen or see or are seeing a communication. Communication in all kind of languages and tools. So it's very important to understand that the responsibility of the message, how the message arrives to the customer, the responsibility is of the communicator, and who designed the communication and who approved the communication and who managed the communication. This is important in the personal life, but mostly in the business life and in the communication life. So the brand is something really important. It, Your Majesty, the brand. For this reason, this is the title and the subtitle of this lesson. And it's so important because the brand means really the success or the unsuccess of a company, or of a policy, of a person, because brand is not only a company brand, can be a city brand, a territorial brand, a government brand, a nation brand, and also some movement brand, culture brand. So brand is something really complex and really simple in the same way. In our field, in all what is packaging, and where is used the label, and so you can imagine how many products use the label tools, the label communication leverage. 25% is the product of quality, 75% the label. And the label is the first cloth of a brand, the first door through which the people come and know and enter in the brand world. So you mean obviously the product quality is important, is more important than every other things. But in the communication, in the first approach of the communication, the 70% of the capability to enter in the mind, in the brain of our customer is the label. And this is something really important to understand, that label is our first approach, our first door in the brain of the customer. And remember, we are speaking always around the brain, how the brain work, how the brain know, how the brain have a perception, how the brain works the emotion, and how the emotion works in the brain, the perception, the sense. So we have to study. And is also amazing because the neuroscience in the last decades discovered so many interesting touch points, how our brain works and how we are our brain. This is important to understand. We are not something double. a body and a brain and perhaps a name. No, we are body and brain in the same moment. So to know the brain function and how the brain works, we know how to communicate also. This is very important because not always all people do this in a real way. So remember, 75%, that is statistic, is what the perception through the label. So what is brand identity for a company? Is created by a design team. This is strategic and related to production, is related to marketing, is related to management. And so the brand identity, we need to work through a brief and to arrive with a storytelling that have to be coherent in all the point, in all the moment, in all the geography of the storytelling, have to be coherent with the value, with the mission, with the atmosphere, with the sense of the brand. And this build the brand identity. And remember, you cannot work to a brand identity only working about the superficial skin of the brand or the company. But you have to work in the deep reality of the company, because all the elements create the identity, and the identity have to be communicated in the right way with coherence. And coherence is the value most important in all the brand strategy and the brand communication, because you can verify by yourself how much becomes important the truth in the social media society, you know, the contemporary society, the social media. The truth is really important. People that can use the personal face and can become credible and becomes really truth in what they say, this is also a very important value of the contemporary truth, because fake news, too much communication, too much sound, too much rumors created the value, the most important value of truth in this moment. So truth is something very important in the communication. And I say is not enough also the truth. The truth have to be well told, well designed, and well communicated. So what when you are a mark, the experience, they create the knowledge. If I know a mark because I have had a user experience or a consumer experience. But a brand, you know, also without having an experience. No, I had never buy a Ferrari. I never drive a Ferrari. I know exactly what Ferrari means as a brand, as a car brand. But other mark, if I don't use or I don't consume or I don't buy, I don't know the value of this mark, the meaning, the sense of this mark. So the difference of mark and brand is this one. The brand you can know without an experience. The mark you need to have a direct experience. And what is the label? Is what you see in this picture is what I said before, is the brand's entrance door, the first brand's entrance door, because our brain, the first door of our brain is emotion, and the emotion is related to perception and to the five sense. And so the label is something that is immediately visible, and in the second time you can touch. And remember that the label, when you are in a shop, you don't only see the label, you take the paper, you see deeper what is right, and you touch also the label. So the material is very important, not only to give the best reproduction of colors, of detail, but also to have a touch, because touch is something very important in our emotion, in our brain. And our brain translates this kind of emotion in information and in memory. And the memory is based about our sense. And then a label is a miniature story. And so is in so a little space, you have to to tell a story, a rich story, a long story, sometimes a long historical story, deep and deep and large. So you have many elements to synthesize, but the strong way, the most important words is to synthesize a very long, deep and large story, many elements, many values. What to select the most important, the priority, and how, what I have to say and to who I have to say this. So it's important the synthesis, and this is a professional work. Remember, it's important that the team, the design team of a label is not only graphic, is not only printing skills, but is knowing the material, the psychology, and also the storytelling. The mix of sense that a label represent. Then I say also what is important to know. Sorry, I have to eliminate this one. From the success to the disaster, and this is something that in the last year I like to inform and to speak with my student or my colleague or my stakeholder, that attention, creativity, design, and all that means communication can be a success and can be a disaster. And there is a method, there is a professionality there to arrive to the success. And this is design. Design is culture and method to transform vision in a real project and in communication is something that can take the contents in the best way to our stakeholder. And this is design. So communication is a project. I show something that can be interesting. Remember, Dolce & Gabbana is a very good company, is one of the best Italian company, very creative, very cultural also in the communication. They use so many heritage of Italy style, story, and local culture, and translate in a fresh communication for fashion. And they create a very important also Dolce & Gabbana style in the communication, using traditional means, traditional scenes, color and shapes to transmit the quality of Italian style, Italian life of style. And also in an ironic way, no? This is in Italy, in Europe, in West, was a very good language. But when you do this in a way, ridiculous way and inappropriate, and I add this value, vulgar language in a country that is have other value and other priority in this value, you have a very, you can have a very dangerous, a big disaster. And this kind of publicity in China that was not so thought and not designed, I think. They translate in a simple way what they do in are doing in Italy in China, don't studying without studying the culture, the sensibility of Chinese market, of Chinese people. So was a disaster. They lost so many money. They have to escape from China in the night, because all the people was against this kind of publicity, vulgar, that was also a ridiculization of China tradition and of China sensibility. And so they lost a very, very important business and dollar and million, billions of dollars in the China market, and are not come out from this disaster. So it's not the creativity and the good shape, good communication in an aesthetic way without a deep study about the sense and the target of the communication can be a disaster. So I think the success is coming from a good process, a good method, a good design. And where is the mistake of Dolce & Gabbana is to use creativity and stereotype stereotype and this create the failure of this operation, because stereotype is was good in Italy, no, because it was a ridiculous way about the dimension of a saucisson and a saucisse. This is can be, yes, ridiculous, a little vulgar also in Italy, but can accepted by the culture and the stakeholder, the public in Italy, but was really not accepted by the young people, not old people in China, but the young people. As you see, you can see in the social media, they do a social fighting against the Dolce & Gabbana. It was all young people, not senior people, because the sensibility about sex in China is really another thing about our culture. So we have to respect the other, the difference. I spoke before about the difference. And the difference, to know the difference, this is culture, this is knowledge. And we cannot do something without this approach. That is a cultural approach, an intelligent approach, a rational approach. It's not something related to sentiment or to morality, or to that is something really important to respect the difference and to represent. So creativity plus method can give us the success. And the method is design, transform vision and sense in feasible project. So design means also something is a process to transform a cultural and immaterial value or contents in something that you can read, that you can see, that you can touch, that you can feel. And this is a project, a very professional process. And attention, without ethics and without empathy, you cannot work in the communication business, because it's really dangerous and it can create many problems if you don't use. What is design? Many people think that design is something related to aesthetic, to the form, to the shape. No, it's not real. Design is coming also from Latin, designium, is live e sim, a creative project activity with the goal to give a meaning to things, to everything, not only object, with shape, function, duration, truth, beauty, and love, projects, method, and culture. Dolce & Gabbana don't use, they use a method in the West communication, they don't use a method for the Far East communication. Because if they use the method, they have not used, they properly don't use it, this kind of communication, but they designed a new communication respecting the scenario of people, of culture, of sensibility, of sense. And studying what is our brain, you if you study this and you are design oriented, you will you don't do this error, because you think you are able to know this kind of danger, and you can avoid this with creativity and design. So design is something related to design thinking, is an approach, is also philosophical and psychological, and also managerial the approach. Is strategic design, because design have to think the future. Is a product service system design, is not only a product design. Many people think that design is only product and the shape of the product. No, design is product, service, system, design. I make an example. When you drink a coffee of Nespresso, they don't invent the coffee, they don't invent the machining of coffee, they don't invent the shops, they don't invent the advertising, they don't invent the opinion leader, but they make it the design of a system, of a services, of a product. So the product was a coffee, and the system is all the distribution organization, and the service also, and to create a bar coffee, an Italian bar coffee at home. This is the needs, the desire that they utilize to design a product, service, system. And this was the success. They don't invent nothing. but a different way to drink and to offer a coffee in our daily life. Brand design, so to project a brand, this is design. Event design, I'm teaching event design in Politecnico. And design management, how you project, you design the management of your company, of your process or your project. Visual design is something related to what we are speaking on now. And graphic design also in the label market, the graphic design is very important. You see the picture that I put in this lesson is all referred about the best graphic solution, but related to brand strategy and brand identity that the paper of Arconvert and Federigoni can give to our works. So design is something more complex and is really important that is will be put in the beginning of the process. Design is the project method, as I said, and culture. Not only for create novelty or temporary profit, but to create innovation and to create value. And for this reason, to create the brand identity. So this is very important to see that design have to see long way to have a strategic goal, strategic arrival point and the strategy, then to design the daily experience of product, of services, of communication. Because novelty is something new. Yes, I can do a new project, no? A new phone with a new format, two new app. But the innovation is something more. Innovation is something that creates a different way, a different relation in the society. So that able to create the evolution of the society. And this means that innovation is more important than novelty. And value is more important than temporary profit, because the temporary profit can come and go. But the value is a value, build value day by day. And a brand identity is built about value and value. So this is another important concept to know, that design is a leverage for the strategic brand strategic process and brand strategic identity, build daily, day by day. From the intangible to the tangible. This is another important approach of design. Design is born many years ago as product design, as a material design, to produce something material. But now we design and manage intangible value. And in the label, and the brand in the label is many parts of the brand identity in the label is immaterial value. That you can transmit and speak with a very good design of this. You can see the label, the very good label are story. This also is and so also related to the to the culture and the scene and what we put in a label speak about the nature of the company. And the customer of the company, he is also Bansky is present. So this means also the position in the market of this brand about also cultural and art expression. Product, service, system design. This is the contemporary design that able to design the complexity and to work in the complexity. And is a complex, integrated, and coherent are three adjectives very important value of the product service system design. Starting from the raw material to the production process, the design of product and services system have to manage all this kind of topics that you can read, no? And is something that is you can see here. From the raw material to the production process that are related, and also when you think in to a label, you have to know the production process and the characteristic of the material, because you can have the success or not success studying exactly this process. Then the distribution, because distribution creates some problem and resolves some problem. So you have to know exactly what is the distribution. Then the post-selling, then the utilization. In design, we speak about the user experience. No, I am a teacher to all my students. I ask, you need to study the user experience. How you can define a solution without thinking what is the experience of your customer, of your user, of the person that use your product or read your communication or your book or every kind of product or service. And then also now in the contemporary needs impose us to study the disposal and the recycling approach of a product or a service, because all our product and services consume energy, material, and you have to study not only to reduce the energy and the material to use and to for your use, but you have also to study what happened after, how this energy, how this material, how all is related to the production process and the user process, the consumption process, are related to the waste and the recycle problem. This is a very 360 grade and holistic approach of the design of product service system, tangible and intangible. I repeat, there are not only tangible value, are the intangible value. And remember, the intangible creates so many problems. Dolce & Gabbana was an intangible error, not a tangible error. Because it was a communication, it was a picture, it was an image, it was a phrase, it was a little movie. No? So it was not really a material, but was something immaterial, some cultural, and the damage was really incredible damage. So material, tangible and intangible, are a system of world. So what is the tangible and intangible in this kind of approach? The brand identity means material, concept, print, graphic, color, storytelling, visibility, brand identity, this is all. And you, the mix of tangible and intangible is really something that you can write. I always, to my students, I say, take a white paper and write. What is the tangible, what is intangible? And the list of all the topics, good topics or problem, or and then the solution, but the list of all the connection between the tangible and intangible, and the list of all the problems, the topics, the alarm, the alert, is really a system to understand, to create a map of problem and then a map of solution, and to decide what is the priority in this one. This is an approach that is related to design. Cognitive bias. You need, and all the humanity needs to know better our brain, because what it means cognitive bias? We born with some cognitive bias that is related to know how to inspire and how to eat by our mother. We have two, three elemental bias. Then all are cognitive and cultural bias born from our experience, from the first day we are in the life and day by day in our life. So you can use the cognitive bias that are important for our survival, because they are related to some emotion that create immediately a reaction in our mind and after our brain in our body. And this, so the bias are automatic and very speed the connection, very speed the synapse, very speed the evaluation that create a immediate reaction. We have this for survival, but we have this also in shopping when we decide something. So it's important to know what are the cognitive bias and to manage the cognitive bias in a right way, not in a worst way. We are our brain. Remember that we are our brain. The old culture divide our brain in the brain, the ideas, the body, and some religions say that we have a name. I don't think so. I think that we are body, aim, identity, and brain in the same element, and is a continuous dialogue, a connection between all these elements, material and immaterial. As we are tangible and intangible, also all the things that we use are tangible and intangible. We are all our brain. So it's important to know how our brain works, and works with synapses, connection, chemical and electric connection, and that inspired by internal input as memory and external input. The memory is also something related to the bias. Sometimes we are bias that make pressure in our brain to take this decision before thinking to this decision. So it's very important to know how our brain works and what is automatic reaction and what coming from bias, cognitive bias, and what are invece thinking reaction, no? Rational reaction, because our brain works about emotion and rationality. So in this relation, it's very important to know how to move, because the synapses are all the mechanism of our ideas, and our ideas create our behavior. And so it's important to know how and who we are and how we work with our brain. There are something elemental things, something symmetric is something that creates inhibition in our brain, and some asymmetric create excitation. So we are in our brain two chemical that exist also in the drug market, something that create adrenaline reaction, so excitatory, and we make a very strong reaction in some dangerous situation, or we produce some relaxing chemical element that create relax and take calm. And these are two leverage of our brain, no? Excitatory and relax, inhibitory and excitatory. So we have to work about this kind of element that is some related to symmetry in one way and asymmetry. And also the color are important, the shape, the color. So in a graphic design, we have to study how our brain works and to be able to speak to our brain. Cognitive bias are useful, but dangerous. Manipulation is something that the neuromarketing use to manipulate our bias to sell more. I don't think this, yes, sell more is important, is ethics, is normal, but to use bias and also to use prejudice to sell, I don't think this is a right way, because perhaps create more profit now, but not really brand value in the end, brand enrichment in the strategy. So I don't know is a good way, the manipulation, but to know how our brain and how our cognitive bias work, this can be good to communicate easier with our brain, but not to manipulate. This is the ethics that you have to decide all the day. Background and prejudice. This is really important. And this is the ancient Chinese proverb, or Indian, I don't remember, but I like to think that it's Chinese. If a bird of worry can fly over your head, this is, you cannot change. But if they build nest in your hair, this you can prevent. And this is I like this metaphor about prejudice. You can have a bad thought, to think some negative against also some people, some animals, some nature. You can think something bad, but you don't need to do something bad. This is the difference. You are not responsible if a bad idea is coming in your brain. You can respond if this idea create a nest and you after change your behavior in a bad, in a worst way. This is, you can decide. And this is a simple ethics, and in communication is very important. So designer is a cultural works that use culture, knowledge, as I say before, and ethical decision and professional way to transform ideas in real things, leverage, opportunity. The prejudice is something that you, is all the world exists in all the person, all the people, in all the culture, in all the men and women, and less in the children, because they learn the prejudice from the parents, from the adult, from the society, but all people have. But remember, you can accept a bird in your head for a second, you have not to accept that this bird, a bad bird, build a nest in your brain, and to have behavior about the prejudice. Remember, also in the Dolce & Gabbana publicity was based about prejudice, about normal and conventional symbols, completely wrong positioned in another culture. So remember how the prejudice to be conformed to some culture and to use this without thinking, this can be very dangerous. Empathy. This is something that I like. We need the empathy in your, in all we are doing. And the empathy is something that this beautiful artist can explain you. There is a movie in Calcedonia publicity in which Julia Roberts are walking, see two young that are fighting and suffer, because he participate to the sufferings of this student and look away. Then he perceive in few seconds that the conflict ends and the young kiss, and he joy for other joys. So participate to the sentiment to the other. So this is the lesson, the best lesson to explain what is empathy. To know that you are not alone in the world, that exists the other, to be curious with the other. So you take the emotion of the other, you participate to the emotion, bad or good, of the other, you suffer or joy with them, and so you are curious, you are interested, you are active in the relation. This is empathy. Without empathy, no design, no brand strategy, I think no good life. So stereotype is existing, but is very, very dangerous. In the communication, there is also some stereotypes that can be helpful, because sometimes it's useful to use the stereotype, but you have to use in an intelligent way, in a right way. Don't to exaggerate, not to use this to manipulate the other, but to communicate. Obviously, if you have a chateau, from place France, you can use some stereotype, because it's something that is related to the territory, to the culture, and communicate this. So black and red also is something that communicate tradition and related in this market, and also the castle. No, how many wine use the castle as a picture? No, many. This can be stereotype. Yes, but I say be careful. Not always you can use a part, because it's immediately your stakeholder can recognize what you are saying, but not exaggerate about this. Also in oil, no? Olive tree, how many oil use this stereotype? Olives, olive tree, and green and gold also. No, this is some stereotype that are helpful, because are coming of the study of our cognitive bias. But don't exaggerate, it always thinks if related to the stakeholder, to the scenario, to the sensibility, the culture, are good or not good, as China and Dolce & Gabbana example teach. This also in whiskey, we have also some stereotypes that you know, no? The square bottle, the rectangular shape, the retro style, the black and white is something that if you speak whiskey, you can speak this. But there is also some new way to represent what you have to see and to communicate in other way, with mix of scene and graphic symbol. This is another, and also this, the Codex Wine design is a new take on a classic piece. This can be interesting. So you can work with fantasy, with creativity, but with design, to transform an idea and creativity in a real good message that has to be a successful. The good message is a message that arrives to your stakeholders and can help the stakeholder to make the choice you like that they have to do. So this is important, is a relation with your stakeholder. Design and brand design and communication design is something related to the relation between you, the product or service that you are working on, and your stakeholder. Is a good relation. Have to. So also creativity can be really interesting for many other kind of solution to use also some different method. This was interesting for the method that the creative and the designer use to arrive to this image, because the brand strategy also to know who are the actor of the brand, in this case the family. So you can work in co-design to involve the stakeholder in the designing of the graphic, but using your skill, your personality. This is another example of very good use of new language, new material, well selected to communicate really the sense of your message. And in this, you can really understand what I mean to create an experience, a visual, a sensitive experience, starting from the label, from the packaging. No? It's obviously the content have to be good, the quality of the product have to be excellent, but how the packaging, the cloth, the label communicate to the stakeholder, because now we have so many products, so many different options that we have to be very strong in the communication. So this is some other example of creativity and reasonable creativity to become recognizable but by the stakeholder. Remember there are three secret, three values, not secret because it's obvious. The first is we need to be attractive. A brand and a product of a brand, service of a brand, first have to be attractive, because otherwise is not recognizable. The second have to be welcoming. The third have to be satisfied. They have to be need to satisfy the experience, because with the attractivity I create an expectation. With the welcoming I start to satisfy the expectation. With the satisfaction is definitely you come in the memory, because the experience in your brain will be put in the memory, and so the next time you will remember this experience, remember this brand, and also you will become ambassador of this brand. So how is important the first meeting with the product? Design and a relationship. Environmental relationship, social relationship, and cultural relationship. This is the approach of design as method and culture to project product, services, or system of product and services. Material is fundamental in the environmental approach, fundamental for system product excellence. Social is ethic, what I say before. Compass between constraints and objective. But ethics is you have to decide in each moment in which part of the world you have to stay, no? To create value or to create only immediately profit, but then no profit, but damage. Because remember, sometimes short way you can gain, but in the second moment you can lose. So it's very important to have an ethic point of view that is not only morality or religion. No, but nothing of this is to think more in the relation of your action in the system of world and nature in social environment in which you live. Culture, research, dialogue locally and globally. Now we live in a very connected people, and you know, there are also countries and and in different place, but the virus don't know these limits, go, and also the culture don't know these limits. So design is respectable about these three levels. Dialogue, the success is the dialogue with design that can interpret needs and trends, promote research, satisfy creativity, and guarantee excellence. This is the what is success. This is success and is durable success. Remember that is sometimes it's easy to have an immediate and temporary success, but it's more difficult to have a continuous success, a growing success, a stable success. This is also brand strategy. Innovation is innovation if it's social innovation, cultural innovation, and behavioral innovation. Otherwise, it's new, something new, but it's not change our life. So this is important to know in our works. So what is in this case, what the communication is becomes important in all kind of product, and how this the company of today, our guest, is important to be able to help us to realize our communication, to give sense, not only to give sell, but to give sense to what we are doing. And this is important starting, as I say before, from the social, cultural behavior, and before for the material also. So material is very important. I show you something very interesting example and case history about the use of design and starting design for label is a design for brand identity. And this is really important because the label that you see are the story that I say before, to a little book, a little story in a very few square centimeter square. But it is important, the storytelling now is really something sophisticated that have to be very simple, to communicate in a very simple and immediate way. This is the word, to make a synthesis. Less is more, as a very important architect say, but I add this concept. Less is more if the less is well designed, is the result of a process, is not something that comes immediately. So this is other kind of what I'm saying, how design can realize beautiful works, and how you can look at the compliment to the photographer of this picture, because you can touch, you can feel the material. And imagine when you take this bottle on the hand, how is important this kind of touch, of feeling and of texture. And this is other solution, also very creative, and also is also the, how the culture can be, the heritage can be innovated in this kind of on the right, you know, the color can becomes a vehicle of message, of atmosphere, of feeling. And so also in this case, how some message, and I say this, you can think a good use of stereotype, no? The black and gold is something that speaks immediately elegance, luxury, important. Now remember, for many, many years, fashion was black, and also design was black. All the designer was black, dressed always in black, all the day in black, because black is something cultural, something intellect, something with value. And gold and black is sure something that our bias, cognitive bias say, okay, this is good, this is precious, is rich. But also we can use white and black in a very simple way, but in a rich message. And also how the beer was in this last decade become very important as wine, and the wine was the example of communication of value of the wine, and also the beer and other drink learned by the wine communication, and how the label is really important, because speak is the first door to know this kind of product. And how it becomes very interesting, very creative, very rich and very complicated. Also is a beer and how this kind of beer can come out from the market and be very recognizable. And also irony in this case, we can see irony, but a very good level of graphics and materials and colors. So, and other kind of innovation is also to use some special color to be helpful in the night, to be recognizable, and also in very light image with some different color to be recognizable in a shop when you buy, and how the material can help this kind of design. And what I say, how the touch is immediately a perception. So it's important to, when we design something, to think to the five sense and take care. This is the message in the final, take care in all the particulars. For this reason, also the technical value of a paper, of an adhesive, of a mix of paper and adhesive, regarding the kind of bottle, kind of use, is very important to take care of all the particulars, to go deep and large, and the design of this kind of communication is very important because it's something that is pro-brand strategy or against brand strategy. And you know how it's difficult to build a good brand, a recognizable brand, a loved brand, and how is easy to lost everything. No? The example of the starting of this lesson always is this one. It's very difficult to build something good, but it's really easy to lost everything with a stupid error, and an error that is coming from not respect and not design process. Take care of what materials, how technology, how much languages, tangible and intangible value. Take care of. This is the excellence that many people in the world say that we are able in Italy to take care of the particular, of the detail. Quality and excellence are the detail, to care the detail. And this is a synthesis that I like to give because I go around the world many, many times, not in the last 1 year and a half, but I start again. And I see the Italian is well considered in the world for two reasons. For lifestyle, because all people in the world think that we are able to have a good life quality, and also the quality, the detail. The quality of the detail creates the excellent. So it's a mix of quality. It's not only an aspect or two, but in the whole, and the whole quality approach. And this is what I said before, design can help this, because design is design for sales team, system of product and services. And remember the last, translate is not enough, isn't enough. You have to interpret it. Also, one of the most important global brands, like Coca-Cola, was able to characterize and customize the communication for different cultures. And also in the graphic, they also worked about the logo, that is, to touch a logo is generally a crime for the marketing of all the company, all the public, the advertising company. No. There is a mistake, is a crime to work about to change the logo. Coca-Cola have the strong position in the market that can change and interpret this for different culture. Remember how we start in this end. Remember that translate, but this is also in the life, is not enough. The interpretation is important. I do always this example. I give this example to my students and my friends. If I put a glass of water in the middle of a table, and I am in this part of the table, and a Chinese man is in the other part, or woman, we are thinking, if I say glass of water, for me is a cold glass of water. For the Chinese, is a warm glass of water. So it's not enough to say glass of water, we have to say cold or hot. So to interpret it, because I have empathy for my guest, Chinese, and I offer a warm glass of water. That is, for Italy, is if I offer to an Italian a water glass of water, he killed me. So is this is empathy, is to think to the other, and not only translate glass of water, but to add a value that is acceptable for the other. So a warm glass of water for a Chinese man, a Chinese friend, and a Chinese friend, when I go in China, many Chinese friends that know me offer me cold water, because they know that I like cold water. The same things when the Chinese friends come in Italy. This is a lesson that is very important in the communication design process. So thank you, and please, the last very important advice is do things and see people. This is really something important for our wellness, our psychological, cultural, and also physical wellness. Do things and see people. Thank you. If you have a question, I am here. Adesso come devo dare welcome. Allora, eccoti qua.
Ci ho pensato io. I've thought of it, Luca.
Thank you
for being here again to all the participants, and thank you, Luca, for providing us with such incredible insights into the, you know, the cultural approach when designing one brand and when advertising. Now it's time for Q&A session. So I ask the participant to please write their own questions in the chat box. We will try to answer some of them because we are a little bit late. So I think we have time for a couple of questions, no more. And as I was saying before, we will get back to you in a second time with a dedicated email to answer your questions, okay? So let's go ahead, guys. Write your question in the chat box. I'm waiting for my colleagues to help me out and tell me a couple of questions. Or here they are. The first one: besides colors, is the label texture a key cultural aspect to consider when approaching a different market?
Sure. This is the answer is sure, because color is something related to two levels. One is the brain, because it's our technical system to know, to have perception, and is a language to our sense. And for this reason, there are also some bias, cognitive bias. We like or not like immediately some color, because in our experience we have bad or good experience. So that create some bias in our brain. The other thing is cultural, because as I say, there are also some standard that I like to make irony. No, why the style, the fashion stylist and the designer, the 75% are all dressed in black? This is something to think, because it's a dress code, no? And wow, you go in London or in Wall Street and are all in gray and with something with the light white line, and all are exact. So we have some standard, no? That we use color to communicate something immediately, no? A priest is in black, because it's immediately they say, I am black. Some other country, you go in Arabic, the businessmen are all in white dress, no? And communicate some other things. So the color is really, really important. And there are also some specialists that study the psychological, but not only the psychological, the neuroscientific approach of our color. And there are some colors that excite and some colors that relax. Depends what we are to communicate.
Okay, and what about texture?
Is the same
for instance,
thing
in a label? Is it texture a key cultural aspect to take
absolutely.
Into consideration?
Absolutely, because remember, I explain you something very, very easy, very experienced. If you have a material very, very natural, very, there is a texture. No? If you have to communicate something technological, it's very shining. So also the texture is communicate something, no? Because communicate in our sense. What I say, the label is the first door, a multi-sense door, because you see, and I have to say compliment to your photographer, Chiara, because the pictures are so expressive for the taste, no? The material. I have a physical perception seeing your picture, and I like so much because you see the, you can touch, no? You have a, and remember, our brain is terrible. As there is some memory related to experience, so I see something and I have a touch experience in my memory, not real, but is real. So it's real because it's in our brain, but it's not real. You don't touch really, but you touch in your brain. So it's really important because also the texture communicate, but also in food, no? In food, the consistency of food. Sometimes I like seafood and many also not cook seafood, and I sense some friends they don't like, not for the what is, but for the sensation.
The taste. Yes,
for the food. This is texture. So it's very important.
Okay, thank you very much, Luca. The last question is paper, plastic, cork, wood, how important is for the label and the secondary packaging the choice of material on a cultural level?
Yes, again, depends on the product and depends what I have to communicate about this product or this service, no? And depends also by the function. But remember, now is very important the sustainable approach to study all what is sustainable. Due not only in the beginning of the process, how I produce this kind of material, but also.
So you mean that Luca. You mean that sustainability is a cross-cultural aspect to take into consideration at the moment, right?
Now I am not so young, so when I started to work in design and product, sustainability is something we speak about, but we don't know exactly how to do. Now it's impossible to start with a product or a services or a product or a system or product without thinking about this, because the market needs it, but I say the world needs this. So we have to be very responsible, but there is really many, many opportunity. I am in Sicily now. I just visited the laboratory in the engineering faculty, and there is a process, and this is interesting also for Chiara, because we can propose some work together, something about this. They are studying a material from the result of the material of the beer, during the process. So can boil a bioplastic using this kind of waste of the process of beer. This is interesting for your company as my work. Now, so sustainability, if you put in the center, you promote also research possibility and start possibility, opportunity. Without positioning sustainability in the first, don't happen nothing. If you put this, you can have really good surprise as today, my surprise here in Sicily. So this is a message, a fresh message, a direct message from this point of view.
Clear, very clear. I'm sorry we have finished our time. So thank you to you, Luca, first of all, for your support and your beautiful presentation. And I want also to thank all the participants who chose to spend their time with us this afternoon. And please let's keep in touch. You can follow us on our social media to stay updated about our upcoming events and webinars. Bye to everybody.
Thank you to you. Ciao.